What's up? This is Lateef The Truthspeaker. Right now I'm on TheFeedBak.com.
What's up, y'all? This is Brother Ali. I'm an MC from Minneapolis, Minnesota.
What's up, everyone? My name is Eligh from a crew called Living Legends.
What up, family? It's Zumbi Zoom, you know what I'm saying? Representing Zion I crew, also the Burners Click.
I kind of started in this game a while ago, back when the independence was all everything. And I started out independent. I'm independent now. I mean, I've been on majors along the way, but I just never really waited for others to give me a shot. I always took the shot myself. And I started early on with Soul Sides, DJ Shadow, Lyrics Born, Gift of Gab, Chief XL, Jeff Chang, Jazzbo. That was the crew early on. And we just pressed up records, put the stickers on them, went around, gave them to people, sold them in stores. I mean, it was like, I remember we put out records and it was like us and Woo. And those were like the independent records in the stores.
I got involved in hip hop when I was a little kid, when I was like 7 years old. Breakdancing, and we called it b-boying, you know, they call it breakdancing now, but b-boying, and just fell in love with music, fell in love with hip hop. And that was in the mid 80s when it was really about partying and just having style. It was all about style. And then in the late 80s, early 90s, things became very, very lyrical, and that's, you know, guys like Rakim and KRS-One and Chuck D, people like that came out, and I just became enthralled with the idea of writing songs and being an MC. And so ever since the late 80s, that's what I've been doing. Part of an independent record label called Rhymesayers Entertainment. Artists like Atmosphere, Evidence, Freeway, MF Doom, Idea and Abilities, Blueprint, Psalm One, Toki Wright, you know, a lot of people. And, you know, we're based out of Minneapolis. And we've been independent for a very long time.
I think I was in the first grade, and I went to a friend's birthday party. And I remember I got there, and he was dressed up all in Adidas suit, right? A windbreaker suit. It was red and gray. I remember it like yesterday. Had a little hood and everything. And he was into breakdancing, and he had Beat Street on. And it was the main thing of the party. Like, Beat Street was on the TV. And, you know, nobody was paying attention to the food or the candy or nothing. We were just watching Beat Street and just into it. And I was blown away. I saw it, and I was like, what is this? First grade, so I was a little kid, dude. And I remember after that, the first album I bought was LL Cool J, I'm Bad. And my mom bought it for me. And from there, I was hooked. It was over. First grade on. By the time I was 13, I was rapping on the yard in circles with all the kids, and it was on from there. I never had a real job since. Hip-hop was my life.
We got in the game, man. I met the producer for our crew, Amp Live, down at Morehouse College in Atlanta. We got signed to a major label in the 90s. We dropped off the label. We formed an independent crew called Zion I. Dropped our first album in 2000, and it's 2012, so you can do the math, man. We've been putting it down for a while.
Yeah, I've been to South by Southwest a few times, although it's grown a lot. It is huge right now.
I've been coming to South by Southwest for a long time. I think my first time here was 2003. It's changed a lot. It's it used to be an indie rock thing. It was like indie rock, punk. They ruled. They were everything. And there was a small little amount of hip-hop, but it was all indie, you know, independent, underground hip-hop.
It seems like this is the most people I've ever seen at South by Southwest, or maybe, I don't know. It just seemed like a lot of people, man. It's off the hook, so much energy, just every show, like, people are cool, you know, it's nuts, man.
I just put out my own solo record recently, Firewire. But the new Lateef record is what I'm working on at the moment. Very excited about it, coming full circle. That's what I'm working on at the moment. I was here also. One of the other projects I'm working on is one that I have with my boy Dan the Automator. Emily Wells is the lead singer, and Kid Koala is the DJ, and Butterscotch Beats is beatboxing and playing keys and singing in it, and I sing back up and rap every once in a while. And Mayor Lowe, who plays guitar and bass with Jack Johnson, is in the group as well.
Me being an albino from the Midwest, I'm a Muslim, and I'm an MC, and that's what I've always been. So, like, you know, I've had a unique story. Had a real interesting life, and so my music really started from that point. As I've grown and gotten older and, you know, told so much of my story and made the points that I wanted to make about myself, it's grown to start thinking about more social things, community things, political things. And so my new album that's coming out in the summertime, Morning in America, Dreaming in Color, is really a more social and political kind of album.
So the album I would like for you guys to know about and to definitely go get is called Therapy at 3. It's me and Amp Live of Zion I. Amp Live produced all the beats. I wrote and handled all the verses and all the lyrics. Very proud of this album. I really hope you guys will go out and at least listen to it, check it out. Because once you hear it, I guarantee you're going to put it on your computer, on your laptop, in your stash. In the future, I got a couple different things I'm working on. Number one is a new Grouch and Eligh album. Me and Grouch are going to sit down and do a whole new album. I'm working on an album with Gift of Gab of Blackalicious, just me and him. I'm probably going to produce most of it, which I'm kind of excited about. He's my boy, and we feed off each other. It's going to be fun. And another one is this cat DNA from the Bay, and he makes bass music, which is basically just 808 music, like hard, a lot of bass shit. And we're doing an album together, an EP, like 7 songs or so. It's gonna be a lot of chopping, cause I chop, I like to go fast. So like da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, just on some just crazy dark bass music. So I got a bunch of stuff coming up, man. You guys stay tuned, keep in touch.
The latest thing we dropped is the Liberty mixtape. Basically a bunch of projects between myself, Amp Live, The Burners, Grouch and Eligh and Amp Live. So it's a bunch of projects we've been working on. This is the new mixtape. I have another project, The Burners. It's an EP coming out in May. And the big project for the year is the new Zion I album. This coming fall, called Shadow Boxing. So check for that, man. Zion I, Shadow Boxing, The Burners' new album in the springtime, man. It's love. Yeah. Shout out to South by Southwest, man. Seeing all my folks out here, man, it feels good. It's a blessing. We've been doing it a long time. Seeing a lot of homies I ain't seen in a while. Want to send a big shout out to the FeedBak.com. Holding down this independent, conscious shit. Hip-hop music, man. We still alive, baby. We keep going, baby. Don't even trip.
Yeah.